Praise the Lord, young people. It's Brother Torrance coming to you. Glad to see you back, going, getting the word. Just wanted to come to you and open up in a word of prayer before we start the word. Before you do anything, please grab your Bibles. All right, let us pray. Dear Heavenly, most gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we come to you again. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this opportunity to bring the word. And thank you for the opportunity to bring it through the social media thing that we're using, the Heavenly Father. Thank you for being able to put it in YouTube and use the iMovie to put together the message, Lord. I ask that you continue to undertake for the kids, undertake for the young people, undertake for those that are in authority over them, the Heavenly Father, give them wisdom and encouragement and strength, Lord, to continue to push forward. Undertake for the young people as we finish out the school year, the Heavenly Father, everything be done decent and well. Prepare for the summer and continue to undertake for safety and protection and health, the Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, pray and give thanks. Amen. Enjoy the word.
Hey guys, welcome back to another Saturday night Bible class. We are so happy to have you all here with us today. We hope that you enjoy today's lesson. And before we begin, please make sure you have your Bibles. My name is Sister Liz. I will be going over the books of the Bible. We'll have Sister Citra provide the memory verse, and then Brother Kogan's going to bring you the lesson. We hope that you all enjoy.
We're talking about history.
There were a couple of guys who were up to some good.
We got Ezra, Nehemiah, they helped build a wall around the neighborhood. We got Esther, Job, and Psalms.
And then we got the books of wisdom.
We got Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, the Song of Solomon. He was a wise king.
Then we're moving right along to the majors.
Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel.
Then you got thrown in the lion's den.
But he wasn't alone.
God was with him.
And then we've got the minor prophets.
Hosea, Jonah, and Amos, Obadiah.
Jonah got swallowed by a big fish on his way to Tarshish. And then we got Micah.
Praise the Lord, young people. I'm Sister Citra, and tonight we'll be doing the memory verse portion of the lesson. Before we get started, let's bow our heads and pray. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you for tonight. Thank you for the young people and adults tuning in. Lord, may you hide me behind the cross so only you may be seen. What's in Jesus' name I pray, amen. Amen, boys and girls, young people, adults. Thank you so much for tuning in tonight. I will be doing the memory verse with you. And tonight we will be having our memory verse in Genesis chapter 39, verse 21. So earlier we asked that you get your Bibles. Hope that you have yours. I have mine with me. We're going to read out of God's word first. And that is Genesis chapter 39, verse 21. And we're going to do the A part. All right. Genesis chapter 39, verse 21a. But the Lord was with Joseph. All right. We are going to do our drills, in which we're going to do it three times together. It is a relatively short verse this week, but all the more so that you can practice it and drill, 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 and have it in your hearts. All right. So, memory verse for this week. Genesis chapter 39, verse 21a. But the Lord was with Joseph. Again, Genesis chapter 39, verse 21 A. But the Lord was with Joseph. One last time, we're going to say it together. Genesis chapter 39, verse 21a. But the Lord was with Joseph. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord, young people. Again, tonight's verse was a little short. However, please make sure that you are practicing God's word and that you're studying God's word. Genesis is the first book of the Bible. We will be studying on Joseph. And so we ask that you guys prepare your hearts for the word that's going to be brought to you by Brother Covian. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, boys and girls. Brother Covian coming to you again with another Saturday message. We have now reached the story of Joseph, which is found in Genesis chapter 37. We're going to go through the story tonight, and not all of the scriptures, but a few of the scriptures. But let's first have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, as we prepare to receive your word and learn about Joseph, dear Heavenly Father, and some things that were going on in his life, we just ask that you would prepare our hearts to receive it. Open our understanding in Jesus' name. Amen.
So the objective for our lesson tonight is to teach that kindness is always the right choice. And also added to that to say that deception is never the right choice. So we want to teach tonight from Genesis 37 and the story of Joseph that kindness is always the right choice and that deception is never the right choice. Now, Genesis chapter 37, and it starts with talking about Joseph's dream. Now, Joseph was Jacob's youngest son. At this time, he's about 17 years old. And Joseph starts to have these dreams, and he shared these dreams with his brothers. And the dreams that he had made his brothers jealous. When you go down to verse 5, it talks about one of the dreams that Joseph shared with his brothers. And he said, and verse 5 says, and Joseph dreamed a dream, and he told it to his brethren, and they hated him yet the more. Verse 7, for behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheaf arose and also stood upright. And behold, your sheaves stood round about and made obeisance to my sheaf, which basically meant that their sheaves bowed down to his sheaves. And his brethren said unto him in verse 8, shalt thou indeed reign over us, or shalt thou indeed have dominion over us? And they hated him yet the more for his dreams and for his words. So again, Joseph is having these dreams. He's sharing them with his brothers, and they're getting upset about it because they kind of hate these dreams. Like, where's he going with this? He's our younger brother, and he expects us to bow down and serve him or something. What is this guy talking about? Then he goes into another dream in verse 9, and he says, and he dreamed yet another dream and told it to his brethren and said, behold, I have dreamed a dream more, and behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars made obeisance to me. So now there's more bowing to him. Verse 10 lets you know he also told his father about that dream. After telling his father about the dream, his father rebukes him. And he said, and this is in verse 10, he said, shall I and thy mother and thy brethren indeed come to bow down ourselves to thee to the earth? And his brethren, in verse 11, and his brethren envied him. But his father observed the saying. In other words, he remembered it. He put it in his mind. Now, as we go on in about verse 12 through 17, Joseph leaves and goes searching for his brothers because his brothers were going out and to feed the flock. So Joseph goes out to look for his brothers. When he went to look for his brothers, let's go down to verse 15. And a certain man found Joseph. This is why he was out looking for his brothers. And behold, he was wandering in the field. And the man asked him, saying, what seekest thou? And he said, I seek my brethren. Tell me, I pray thee, where they feed their flocks. So he tells him in verse 17. And the man said, they are departed hence, for I heard them say, let us go to Dothan. And Joseph went after his brethren and found them in Dothan. Now, Joseph gets to Dothan, and now a conspiracy starts. His brothers are now plotting and planning to kill him initially, but then Reuben, one of the older brothers, steps in and says, we're not going to kill him. What we're going to do is we're going to throw him into a pit. So down to verse 24, they grabbed Joseph when he came to them, and they took him and cast him into a pit, and the pit was empty, and there was no water in it. And they lifted up their eyes and looked, and behold, a company of Ishmaelites came from Gilead with their camels bearing spicery and balm and myrrh, going to carry it down to Egypt. Now the plan became from his brothers to sell Joseph to the Ishmaelites, to sell him into basically slavery. So that's what they agreed to do. Now they decided to sell him to the Ishmaelites. Has anything kind been done to Joseph at this point? Has the envy and the hate and anger driven his brothers to do some pretty, pretty bad things? Yes, it has. And that's the reason why, going back to our objective, we're learning that kindness is always the right choice. Deception is never the right choice, okay? So Joseph is sold to the Ishmaelites. His brothers sold him to the Ishmaelites. Verse 28 lets you know it was for 20 pieces of silver. They sold their brother. They sold their brother. They were so frustrated, hated him so much because of his dreams. That was kind of like the last draw, and they decided it would be a good idea to sell their brother. Now, remember, Jacob has a coat of many colors that his father gave him. The beginning of the chapter talks a little bit about the coat. But anyway, the coat that he gave him, they said, let's take the coat. And now they're putting together a plan to make their father, Jacob, believe that something happened to Joseph, because now they have to cover up what they've done. They said they were going to kill him first. Then they decided to throw him in a pit. Then after throwing him in a pit, they said, you know what, let's just sell him. So they sold him to the Ishmaelites. And now they have to deceive their father. Deception, never the right choice. And they took Joseph's coat and killed a goat of the, and killed a kid of the goats and dipped the coat in the blood. That was verse 31. And they sent the coat of many colors, and they brought it to their father and said, this is what we found. Know now whether it be thy son's coat or no. So now they've brought the coat to Jacob, and they've deceived him, and Jacob mourned. He was very hurt. He was very sad over what has happened with his son Joseph, because he loved Joseph. And now he mourned. He was upset, and he was inconsolable. He didn't want anybody to comfort him during this time of mourning for his son, because he's thinking that his son is dead. And verse 36, and the Midianites sold him into Egypt unto Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh's and captain of the guard. Now, the question that we need to ask ourselves is, do we really think this is something that God wants us to do? Does he want us to be dishonest? Does he want us to lie? Does he want us to be deceptive? No, he does not. Think about every place that this anger and frustration with their brother, this envy towards him, has taken them. It's taken them down the path of lies, and they have to continue to lie and do all these things to cover up because of what they lied about. Have we ever put ourselves in that situation before? Have we ever, as kids, even as grown-ups, have we put ourselves in a situation before where we lie and then we cover our lies and all that? It becomes a wicked, evil mess. That only thing we had to do was tell the truth and go to the Lord Jesus. He'll clean us up. He'll forgive us and move forward. So what we have to learn how to do, young people, adults as well, we got to learn to be honest. We got to learn how to watch things that will lead us to being angry and deceitful. We got to keep our eyes on the Lord. We don't want to go with deceit. We don't want to go with deception. We don't want to lie. Envy can get us there. So we don't want to be envious of what somebody else has because of where it could potentially lead us. We don't want to be anything like the brothers who will put together a plan like this against their own family. Just think about how upset they have to be to do something like this against their own family. So I pray that we, the believers in Christ, never allow ourselves to get in a situation where we would go this far. Even kids, you know, when it could be something small that we may tell a lie to our parents about, then we got to cover it up. I remember being a kid and lying about something, and then I have to cover it up and keep covering it up. And we just don't want to be those type of people, because those problems could lead well into us as being adults while we're still doing those terrible things. So we need to keep our eyes on the Lord. We need to do what he says, and we need to remember that kindness is always the right choice, and it is definitely the right choice for us as Christians. We should always choose to be kind.
Amen. All right, as we continue, I want to talk about something very, very important. We have so much going on in our world right now, and we just had a message of people who are listening to what Jesus has to say, who are sitting at his feet, his disciples, his children, people who know him and people who are getting to know him and hopefully saying yes to Jesus Christ. But what if you haven't said yes to Jesus Christ yet? How do you establish a personal relationship with him? How do you know that when you leave this earth that you're going to go to heaven? There's so many people afraid right now because of this pandemic that we have going on. School has been canceled. Businesses are closed. People are stuck in their houses, and everybody's panicking. And some people are panicking, not everybody, but some people are panicking because they're like, what's going on? You know, like, what do I do next? And they're afraid. But for the believer, these should be exciting times for us, because I believe that God has once again slowed everything down so that we can all get our focus back on him. And this is also an opportunity for us to tell people about Jesus and how they can get to know him. So we'll talk about the way to heaven. Okay. Why did God give his son? It's because he loved the world so much. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Jesus came to the world. The word became flesh. He lived, he died, and he did that for us so that we could be saved. That's why he gave his son. He loved us so much. He didn't want us to die and go to hell. He wanted us to be with him. So then you may ask, well, why do I need Jesus? What is my need for Jesus? Why do I need him? We need Jesus because we have sinned. I have sinned. Sometimes we sin by getting into fights. So many other things that we do. We disobey our parents. Our sin brings sadness. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23 says. That's why we need Jesus, because we have sinned. Sin separates us from the love of God. There's a penalty for sin. If we don't accept Jesus, there's a penalty for sin. Sin must be punished. Read this line right here. Sin must be punished. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. That's found in Revelation 20:15. And it says again, for the wages of sin is death. But, and thank God for this word, but right here, B-U-T. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Romans 6:23 is where that scripture is found. Okay. So what did Jesus do for you? What did Jesus do for me? He was punished in my place. He was punished in your place. Okay. He is not still dead. He is alive and he's in heaven. He took the punishment for our sins. 1 Corinthians 15:3-4, pardoned for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. Okay? So what do I need to do? How do I accept this gift? How do I become a member of God's family? How does my name get written in the Lamb's Book of Life? How do I know that when he returns, I will be with him? Okay? For again, for the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. He gives us a gift. The gift of God is to receive Jesus Christ, to accept salvation from Jesus Christ. That is how we establish it. That is how we establish a relationship with Jesus Christ. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. That is found in John 1:12. Okay, so we must receive God's gift. Do you want to receive God's gift today? Do you want to receive his gift? For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, says Romans 10:13. So there's a prayer that we need to pray if we want to be in the family of God. It's a very simple prayer that if we pray it and we mean it, we immediately be born into the family of God. And that prayer reads, and if you want to just pray it right now, you can bow your head, close your eyes right where you are, and just say this prayer right along with me. You can say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I am sorry for my sins. I believe that you died on the cross to pay for my sins and rose from the dead. Please come into my heart today. Come into my heart and life and save me. Help me to live for your glory. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. If you prayed that prayer, what you need to do now is reach out to, you have just been born into the family of God, first of all. And now what you need to do is reach out to, your spiritual leaders here at the Abundant Life Bible Mission, the leadership in this group, you can reach out now. And we'll tell you how to become a disciple, how to build that relationship with Jesus Christ and continue to grow in his faith and grow in his love. And next thing you know, you'll be telling your friends about Jesus. You'll be telling other people how they can be saved and how they can have a relationship with God. And that is the most important thing, especially during these times right now. We don't know when the Lord is going to return. But a lot of biblical prophecy is being fulfilled right now with everything that's going on. It is being fulfilled, and the Lord is coming back soon to take us where? to take us to heaven. So what you just learned was how to get there. And the way to get to heaven is through Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for again for this time. Thank you for this class. Thank you for this message. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the opportunity to still get online and share with the children. We ask that you would keep them engaged, keep them focused, help them to build upon what you've started teaching them, help them to draw closer and closer to you. In Jesus' name we pray and give thanks. Amen.